Hey everybody, how's it going? So today I'd just like to give a shout out to Hawaii with regards to their vote on House Bill 1884. House Bill 1884 is the Right to Repair Bill. Requires original equipment manufacturers of digital electronic equipment to make a documentation, parts, and tools available to independent repair providers and owners for the purposes of diagnosis, maintenance, and repair on fair and reasonable terms. The bill that we've been discussing this entire time. I did miss a hearing on it, but it doesn't seem like the hearing that I missed on January 30th actually mattered, because if you click here on votes, I will just zoom in on there so you can see, they voted in favor 8-0. There were 8 politicians that showed up, and all 8 of the politicians voted in favor of the bill. And if you want to see who those individuals are, if you click right here, you'll see their names. And I think it would be great if people who lived in Hawaii reached out to these 8 representatives that voted in favor of the bill over here and said, thank you very much for voting in favor of my consumer rights. You know that these 8 representatives are going to have a line of lobbyists out the door talking about how batteries explode, how magnetometers explode, how this is going to be terrible, how it's going to ruin the economy, ruin the gaming business because the game plays the console, and TikTok is going to get installed on their phones, and fear, uncertainty, doubt. So I think that it would be great if residents of Hawaii reached out to these politicians and said thank you for voting in favor of my consumer rights. Now, there is going to be another hearing. This is a House bill, and there is going to be a hearing for the Senate bill in just a few days, right here. This is going to be Hawaii Senate Bill 2496. This is on February 6th, 9:30 a.m. in Conference Room 229. I'm not going to be there for this bill, but it would mean a lot to me if you watch my videos and you own a repair shop in Hawaii, or you just fix stuff from your house, or if you just find this to be a fun hobby and think that what the lobbyists typically say against this bill is crap, or if you watch my videos and just think it's ridiculous that I have to buy a $129 battery case, throw away the battery, and rip off an ISL 9240 that I then have to reball rather than buy a $10 chip from Intersil just because Apple decided to be dicks, it would mean a lot to me if you would show up at this hearing and testify in favor of the bill on February 6th, 9:30 a.m. in Conference Room 229. There are several reasons that I'm not going to be able to make it. The first is that it seems like in Maine that they're interested in hearing more about the bill. Certain amendments have been made so that, you know, they're going to exclude areas like logging equipment and other stuff so that there's less reason to oppose the bill. And I cannot be in 2 places at once. So that's one of the problems here. I have 13 employees, and they're all great board repair people. They're not pretend lobbyists. So I'm going to be in Maine. I can't be in Maine and Hawaii at the same time. The second is that it's, from what I've heard, they're not really interested in hearing testimony from out-of-towners or mainlanders. So if I show up as somebody who's spent 4 days of my life in Hawaii, they're not going to really care as much what I have to say. If anything, it may actually look bad on the bill because it's going to be like, what are these out-of-towners showing up in favor of? What is the point of that? You know, kind of like what Ernie Chambers was saying in Nebraska when he was going, what brings you to Nebraska? So if I show up and I testify in favor of the bill, I could actually hurt the chances of it getting passed, not help it. And the third reason I'm not going to be there is, honestly, it's just starting to get expensive. So I've spent about $5,000 or so in travel expenses. I'm going to be spending more going to Maine. And Hawaii is about a $1,300 flight for Erica and I, not including any hotel or anything. That's if we get the seats that hurt, where, you know, like after 3 or 4 hours, I wound up having back pain for 3 days. If I want to get seats that are not painful, it's going to be like $4,000. And I have a choice. I can either head over to Maine, where there's a lot of work to be done in convincing the politicians that this is a good bill to be passed at an affordable flight, or I can go to Hawaii, where it seems like the work has already been done. They already know everything I have to say. It's not like I'm going to be preaching to the choir, and I'm going to spend an additional $4,000 over what it would cost to go to Maine to do that. So it seems like it makes most sense for me to go to Maine. And lastly, the people in Maine seem to not mind hearing from out-of-towners, whereas in Hawaii, I hear they do. So I'm not going to be here in Hawaii on February 6th because I will be in Maine. But it would mean a lot to me. It really would. If you watch these videos, if you own a repair shop, if you do repair as a hobby, show up, because you know, especially with the fact that they voted this much in favor of the bill in the House, you know that there's going to be a barrage of lobbyists that show up, and they're going to be on their usual BS of the TikTok installed and the gameplay and the console that explodes. And it's important that people be there to refute these points. And I think it would mean a lot to those politicians as well to see that local people show up, not just people from out of town. In Maine, one person signed in the sheet in favor of the bill that was from Maine. Wouldn't it be awesome if there were maybe 12 people from Maine that signed up in favor of it? Same thing over here. Wouldn't it be awesome if there were a lot of people that were from Hawaii that were these politicians' constituents that showed up, that were there, that were people that were their voting base? I think this would be great. Also, it would mean a lot to me if someone would show up and record the hearing as well. I do enjoy listening to the counterarguments. I do enjoy going through the counterarguments. And I think that there we are going to kind of create a stigma around lying to politicians if more and more people are privy to what it is lobbyists say to try and counter the points that we're making. So if someone shows up and makes a point that is ridiculous, like that you're installing TikTok on the thing and this is going to explode and Mactrometers explode, I'd like to see less of that. And I think the way we see less of that is by shining a light on it. I'm not there, so I'm not going to be able to record it. But if someone in Hawaii has a camera, but most importantly, an audio recorder that will take an XLR in, that would be great as well. So even if you're not able to get it in sync, I'll figure out a way to do that later. But if someone could provide me with audio and video of this hearing on the 6th, I would be immensely grateful. If there's someone that, you know, if you have an XLR in on your camera, or if you have some sort of little Zoom recorder so that you record for that, because honestly, the audio is more important than the video to me. If you use the mic that's built into your camera, it's going to sound like total crap. But they usually have an XLR panel in any of these legislative rooms, whether it's in Maine or Nebraska or Washington. Most places have mic level output at the panel, and Washington was the only one that had line level output at the panel. So it would be best if you had a recorder that did both. I do have a dream of someday being able to train my own team of lobbyists, Rossman Lobbying Group, and how to rebut opposition arguments and speak to senators and assembly people in a way that is not only engaging so that they stay awake for what we have to say, but also in a way that rebuts the fear, uncertainty, and doubt that professional lobbyists, whether they're working for CompTIA or the CTA or AHAM or anybody else, come up with. When they say that a magnetometer is going to explode in your microwave if this bill passes, I need somebody there to point out and say, no, A, there's no such thing as a magnetometer, and B, it's not going to explode. I would love to do that, but unfortunately, I'm not at the point of being able to afford the additional $20,000 to $40,000 that it would take so that I can hire people across multiple states to just travel around on a full-time basis and meet with these senators and assembly people and show up to every single hearing if there are three at the same time. I'm more than happy to go to as many hearings as I can go to, but I can't show up at two at once at the moment, unfortunately. I'd like the ability to do that in the future, but I can't now. So if you're able to help me by showing up at this hearing, if you are a resident of Hawaii, that would mean the world to me. Thank you very much. And as always, I hope your magnetometers are not exploding.